So the purpose of the Chobani Women Initiative is to build a stronger sense of community among women at all areas of the company. So from South Ed to Twin Falls, New York City, here in Norwich, and in Australia. The events have largely been focused on leadership, on how to make more of an impact on your team, how to make more of an impact on the company, the brand, and the organization. But I think at the end of the day, a lot of the more personal reflections on how to improve yourself, how to invest in yourself, how to bring your passion and your energy to work. We talked a lot about that today, for instance, in Norwich.
How do you as a leader and manager support and empower other people on your team?
I think it's empowering each other every single day. Remember to empower the person next to you and the person by your side. And remember that it's so important to support each other every single day.
How you've made people feel. It's the most important thing. You can help them, you can do them, but people are going to remember how you made them feel. I don't know who quoted that, but it's a great quote. The most important thing is, you know, your friendships and supporting each other and being happy for each other and, you know, celebrating each other's successes.
And learning to be a good listener and helping people to, you know, find and devise their own solutions, I think, has been really big for me.
You can lead from anywhere that you are. And so leaders really are people that help other people look good and set them up for success and let them look, shine brightly.
I've always said there's no time like the present. When somebody's done something really great, and either above you, below you, beside you, wherever you sit within the organization, send that email to say something positive about them and about that effort right then and there.
Come from being true to myself and being comfortable in my own skin and not changing, I think, my beliefs, the things that I feel strongly and the things that make me who I am in order to find success. So being able to find that common thread between personal and professional and allowing myself to be true to myself.
Happy to go to work and happy to go home. Embrace what they're doing, get the most out of it that they can, even if they're finding it's not their favorite thing, and really, you know, stick with it because there's probably something in there, a lesson you're going to learn or something you're going to really take away from that.
We do let people know how we want to be, you know, worked with, and I think we need to set those boundaries and be really careful and distinct about how we set them.
People are going to give you a lot of feedback, and you need to take from it what you can do something with. More quickly you can address a challenge or an opportunity for improvement, the better it is.
I'm your friend, I'm your coach, I'm going to be here, and I'm going to help you be more successful. So I think it's so much easier for somebody to receive it that way.
I think the most constructive feedback either received or given is when expectations have been set up front. Because I think the worst experiences that I've had, either being the person giving somebody feedback or receiving it, is when it's news to you. When that's the first time that you've ever heard it. And you're like, what? It's really just putting your cards on the table and understand what you're working for and making sure you're on the same page. So when the feedback comes, it can be within that structure so that it's not a surprise and it doesn't make you feel defensive. It's within the context of what those goals and expectations are. I think humor helps me de-stress. I think humor helps me put things in perspective. Nobody died.
That
always sort of makes me giggle afterwards, like, all right, we did it. Humor, professionally, personally, it's what gets me through.
Sometimes there's a tendency, especially when you're dealing with anybody who's, you know, a higher up or someone that you report to want to, you know, just, you know, say, yeah, well, you know, make that happen. And sometimes that's not a real honest answer. You know, there may be reasons why, you know, you feel like the timeline's not reasonable or the goal is maybe not right. And you have to be willing to kind of step out and say that. Mm-hmm. And think about it as a way to get ahead as much as I think about it as a way to do the job right. And at the end of the day, that's really what I'm focused on. So
I think job, and like you said, it's that first time that you're, and you have to be willing to hear what's coming from the other side of the table. If you don't want to hear it, then it's going to be difficult. It's being able to take the positives out of all the people in your lives and work through that.
But what inspired me most is that every time we bring people in from the outside to Chobani, they get it. And I think that we do show that a lot to other people, if they don't have the pleasure of coming into the four walls at our Chobani. But I love seeing somebody's face when they leave here and they've been here for the first time. They are our brand ambassadors forever. And you just can't put a price tag on that.